Good afternoon from Sochi as we prepare to get underway for the Russian Grand Prix. The championship battle has some time to go yet, but still expect no quarter to be given here on this circuit that made its debut in 2014 and has already seen some classic racing. Situated just 3 miles from the Georgian border, the 3.6 miles Sochi Autodrome has two notable overtaking opportunities into turn 1 and then turn 13. 18 corners in total here, 12 to the right and 6 to the left, and it's an average lap speed of around 130 miles per hour. And alongside me to take you through it all is none other than Anthony Davidson. This was a circuit that I think in its inaugural race got off to a bit of a shaky start, but since then it's really drawn the fans in and become a very popular event. What do you think changed?
Well, this just goes to show the importance of fixing problems as and when you discover them. As a complete unknown quantity in 2014, the tyre choice was quite conservative, which didn't really allow much in terms of different strategy options. So it was pretty much as you were from lights to flag. But that was a great learning experience, and we came back the next year and had a really exciting Grand Prix, with battles for the podium going on all the way to the final lap. So hopefully we'll be treated to more of the same this year.
We're almost ready to go then, and this is what the starting grid looks like for today's race. Sebastian Vettel has a clear track ahead of him today. He starts in pole position, edging out Raikkonen, who'll start P2. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have a McLaren, Ocon, Nico Hülkenberg, and Sorotkin, Magnussen, Leclerc, Sainz, and Lance Stroll, Perez, Hamilton, Daniel Ricciardo. They've taken a grid penalty, and Bottas, Verstappen, Grosjean, Pierre Gasly, and Marcus Ericsson. Alonso and Brendan Hartley rounds off the grid. And now it's time to head down to the track.
Okay, watch out at the race start. There will be faster cars trying to get past. See if you can hold them off.
Zdravím vás, jsem F261 a dneska vás vítám u 16. závodu 4. sezóny mé kariéry v F1 2018. Kde jsem konečně zajel zase po a hned kvalifikace, teda jak to mám říct, prostě jsem zajel třetí místo v kvalifikaci. Jsem na startu za oběma vozy Ferrari. A bude to další.
What happened? Let me know you're okay.
Kontakt s Renaultem Carlose Sainze. Teď tady zavírám Raikkonenovi a takhle se už rozmlacuji. Neskutečně šílený úvod.
We're in a better grip position than we were expecting.
Absolutely. Nedokázal jsem.
Virtual safety car deployed. Slow down and maintain a positive delta. Virtual safety car is deployed.
Já se to strhla, velká milá. Tam končí jeden zisu. Souvestí jeden zisu Toro Rosso a také McLaren. Nový kolega skončil. A je to Brandon Hartley, který bourá s Fernandem Alonsem. Tady z pohledu Marcus Ericssona. Tam vzadu se srazili dva jezdci a Fernando Alonso končí.
Check your MFD for a new strategy option. Okay, copy that. Virtual safety car is ending. Maintain your pace until the green flag. VSC ending. Wait for green.
Si možná prohlédneme, jak kolidovali Brandon
ERS deployment to overtake mode. Race is over. He's had to retire the car. We're approaching the pit window. You'll be on the ultrasofts. Nice work. That brings you up a place. okay. That was a big one. Confirm you're okay, please.
A druhý kolo.
That looked bad. Are you alright? Let me know you're alright. Is 8.2 seconds. What happened? Let me know you're okay. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. Okay, clear. Virtual safety car, virtual safety car. Reduce speed immediately and keep a positive delta. Okay, slow down, slow down. Your delta is negative, which means you are too fast. Reduce your pace. Understood, copy that.
Končí, ale není sám. Jak se stalo, že o to byli jak Pierre Gasly, tak Marcus Ericsson, tak Kevin Magnussen? Určitě bude, to bude mít za následek ta mela. Tady Pérez to ještě přežil jen tak tak. Tohle je Haas. Romana Grosjeana, tady Stroll, Hamilton, Verstappen, Bottas. Asi už nejsou na grafice a končí v závodě.
Drop your speed, our delta is too low and we risk a penalty. Slow your pace immediately. VSC ending, we're going green. Maintain positive delta until the green flags. Virtual safety car is ending. Maintain your pace until the green flag. VSC ending, wait for green.
Se mnou Lewis Hamilton, Romain Grosjean.
That was our last stop. No more scheduled pit stops.
Překročení traťových limitů. Zase. Ty vole. Já vám fakt musím všechno. Tohle to už je překročení traťových limitů z druhé strany.
Was in the pits. To leader, 8.9 seconds. Some information on Verstappen. They have an issue with their car. They're going to be slow. Gap to the car in front is 2.0 seconds. Are you all right? Engine off, engine off.
Takhle jsem na to doplatil.
that place back. ERS deployment. It's time to use some of this charge. Is 3.0 seconds. Five laps of fuel remaining. Front is 8.4 seconds. race. We need to stay on form. There's 4 laps of fuel remaining. Distance to the leader is 31.1 seconds.
Je na Verstappen nebo Grosjean? Verstappen a Grosjean, tentokrát se na tuto podíváme. Musel příliš zpomalit, aby nevrazil do...
Green flag. Ahead is 20.6 seconds. There's only 1 lap of fuel remaining. This is your final lap of the race. okay. That was a big one. Confirm you're okay, please. Clear. Okay, pick up rubber and bring it home.
A great win then for the Maranello team today. So, how exactly did they set themselves apart from the pack today?
Well, staying out of trouble was probably the most important factor here. In a race where half the field weren't classified at the checkered flag, you were able to guarantee a good result by basically keeping the car running. With their pace and a decent strategy as well, I don't think the race was ever really in doubt.
Here come our winning drivers then, out onto the podium at the end of a thrilling Grand Prix. The drama and excitement are over, and it's time to let it all sink in. Congratulations to our top three today. And now let's take a look at the driver's standings. Well, the gap at the top of the championship has been cut down after a difficult race today for our championship leader. Now then, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
I have to give it to Brendan Hartley. Consistency, good battle, sensible driving. He can be pleased with that performance.
And now let's take a look at the constructor's standings. So then, Ferrari have now moved out of sight and out of reach. It's another triumph for the Italian team as they claim the World Constructors' Championship. There'll be plenty more twists and turns to come this season. I hope you can join us at the next race to see just who will come out on top.
Jak se to stalo? Připravil tam je na chvost pole. A já ten vytlačil. Brendan Hartley nenechal to Fernando Alonsovi. do sandwichi s Leclerkem a Perezem. Tak tady. Incident. Že co se potom stalo? Tak to bude asi jenom důsledek. A tak co to tady? Ukažte mi ten jeho vlast. Proč předával sakra? Ježi, to není podstatě Romain Grosjean. A tak tady Marcus Ericsson trefil. Romain Grosjean je Grosjean. Mohlo to být skon... Vás nejenom s poškozeným předním křídlem, jenže pak do něj ze zadu zrazil Romain Grosjean a jeho trefil Marcus Ericsson. Takovým Marcusem nezareagoval. A tady Marcusa vyžádala další tři oběti závodu.
Good day today. Tell us about it from your perspective. You're beating all expectations. Would you say we all underestimated you? You had a few bumps and scrapes today. Who would you say is at fault? Well, thanks anyway.
Poskočí Lewisi Hamiltonovi a dostanou se vlivu tě také před Fernanda Alonza. O, pokles morálky.
Excellent result today. Finishes like that will look good on your contract reviews. On to the next one. Here we can adjust the terms of our proposal. The more ambitiously we set our targets, the more willing the team will be to give us better perks. We'll have a few chances to suggest a deal, but we need to be careful. If a proposed contract exceeds your value to the team, it will be rejected, and too many attempts will leave us stuck with the original offer. Our proposal has been accepted. The new contract will take effect on the next race weekend.
18. místo, závod 13. místo. Samozřejmě zůstávám týmovou jedničkou. A Hardy, co se týče challengeů.
If it were me, this is probably what I'd invest in.
Přesně, kliknu na F1, na recommend upgrade, a tady major.
I recommend we could go for something like this.
Že my už v této sezóně vyvíjet nebudeme. řekli, jaké upgrady nastanou během velké ceny Japonska. Před velkou cenou Japonska, to si teď ukážeme a pak se rozloučíme. Děkuji vám, že jste se dívali a zatím na shledanou. Programu, což je pro mě lehké. O, ale pozor! Závod bude totálně mokrý. Vlastně bych si dalo říct, že ve třetí sedmině závodu úplný liák, uvidíme. Ale liák to bude rozhodně. A z vývoje pouze Force India a Zauber donesl upgradey. Je teď na čtvrtém místě v té výkonnostní tabulce, jenomže tahle výkonnostní tabulka vlastně vůbec nic neznamená. No ale můžete se na co těšit a ten liák, který nastane v Japonsku. A teď už vážně, nashledanou.